Hello friends and welcome again to our channel, The Teacher. In this video, we are going to learn about another shape tool called TextBox, which is one of my favorite tool in the Insert Shape drop-down menu. It is a special tool and that is why I am publishing a separate video just for this single shape tool. TextBoxes help you to easily accomplish the tasks that seems difficult when you start working with various objects in a single document. So, let's get started. You can draw a new text box from the Shapes drop-down menu of Insert tab under Basic Shapes. As its name suggests, a box in which you can easily type the text without applying any extra effort. I mean, if you want to type text in any another shape except for a text box, then you have to right-click in the middle of that shape and then have to choose Add Text command from the context menu. So you may type the text in that shape. But for the text boxes, you don't need to do any extra efforts. Draw a text box and there you already have the cursor within it and can easily type the text. You might already have seen several documents in which you may have noticed that several text boxes have been written inside the text boxes. Another advantage of writing inside the text boxes is that you can easily move a text box to any desired position that you like, just by dragging and dropping them to the desired place. And even you can easily place a text box inside the margins area. As text boxes are adjustable, you can also easily adjust the height and width of a text box by holding from the white circles, which appears when you select a text box. If you like, then you can also have an accurate custom size for your text boxes by applying height and width dimensions in the size section of the format tab. Word 2016 also gives you the opportunity to use predefined and pre-formatted text boxes from the text section of insert menu. Here you can either select a predefined text box or can click on draw text box to draw a box of your own. Keep in mind that when you draw any shape inside your document, either it is a text box or any another shape, then the default layout behavior of the shape is in front of text, which means the text written inside your document will be behind the shape and the shapes by default will be on the top of the text. So the same applies to the text boxes. But as you draw a new shape or text box, the layout option button appears alongside the shape and you can easily adjust the text wrapping around the shape. You can choose the desired layout option as required, just as I would like to go with the scale layout option for this document. You can also choose the layout options from the Wrap Text drop-down menu of the Format tab. As a text box itself is a shape, so you can also get the advantage of using format menu commands over the text boxes. Like you can easily fill a desired color from the shape fill drop-down menu. And you can also have a variety of options for the text box outline, like outline color, width, and line styles. In Word 2016, when you add a new text box, the default text alignment option is top for text boxes, which means text will start appearing on the top of the text box. Whereas, let's say for an oval, the default text alignment is middle. You can change the text alignment option for any given shape from the Align Text drop-down menu of Format tab and can place the text at desired position within the shape. Moreover, you can also change the direction of the text written inside a shape, and there you have three options in the Text Direction drop-down menu of Format tab. Horizontal, which is the default direction, Rotate All Text 90 degree, and Rotate All Text at 270 degrees. The options itself saying that Rotate All Text, which means you cannot rotate a particular piece of text within a shape. Whenever you will apply the Rotate Text command, it will rotate the entire text within from the shape and doesn't matter if you select a particular text or not. Keep in mind that whenever you insert a new shape inside your document, either it is a text box or any another shape, the default fill color of the shape always will be white. It is important to remember because we usually ignore this or does not notice because the page that you are working on is also white. But let's say that if I change the background color of the page from the design tab, then you will immediately notice that the shape fill color is white. So here is an interesting tip that you might find useful for your day-to-day tasks. It is not always necessary that you would always like to show the boxes along with the text. You rather like to place the text in the page margin area and also want to change the text direction, but you don't want to show that the text is written inside a box. So what you can do is, you can remove the outline color of the text box from the shape outline drop-down menu and set it to no color. Isn't that simple? But as I said earlier that the default fill color of a shape is white. So another time, let's say that you want to place another piece of information close to this hidden text box. Sometimes when you draw two or more text boxes closest to each other, one box might hide the another one because of its white fill color. So what you can do here is, you can remove the fill color as well, just like no outline color. And for this, click the Shape Fill drop-down menu from the Format tab and then click No Fill. This trick could be very much useful when you want to place the text to certain location and want to rotate the text as well, but don't want to show the box along with. So No Fill and No Outline will be your best options to easily hide a text box. Certain times you might also need to work with several objects within a single page, where you require to place text alongside pictures, tables, or other objects. Then it becomes hard to wrap text around those objects. That time you can draw a text box at the desired location and can then easily hide them by no fill and no outline options. Just like the text direction command, text boxes also give you the opportunity to freely rotate the text to any degree required by holding the text box from the curve arrow button. Word 2016 also gives you the opportunity of linking two or more text boxes together by creating a link between them. To do this, select the first text box and then click Create Link button from the Format tab and then click inside the another text box. Benefit of linking two or more text boxes together is, when the first text box will get filled with the text, then the text will automatically start following to the next linked boxes. Moreover, before ending this video, another small tip that you might find useful is, anytime if you like, then you can also insert a table inside a text box. This way, you can easily adjust the table to any location, or can write text alongside the table, or even can place two tables side by side. So, I hope you will find this video informative and useful. Tell us by leaving your comments, sharing this video with your friends, and by hitting the thumbs up button. Thanks for watching, and I will meet you people in the next video. Bye and take care.